Are you one of those people who have a ton of pictures like me, or have loose stuff just lying around and want somewhere where you can display them without the use of picture frames to consume additional space? Trust me, I know, it can get a little frustrating. Who wants to buy 10, 20, or even 100 picture frames anyways? I know, why not just make one huge picture display board? This DIY display board, and it's really easy and inexpensive to make, and it would even make like the perfect Christmas gift for someone special. It would be perfect for those who are busy people who want to keep track of like their to-do list, like their life, their memories, anything like that. It's a good keep safe display board. Like, you can display your pictures, anything that you like. Here I displayed my medal from high school when I graduated. It says Ontario Scholar. I just have like pictures. Oh, don't mind my teeth. These are just pictures that I got from like my dentist, because I don't know, I just wanted a picture of my teeth for some reason so they can analyze it, and I just kept it. This I got from elementary school way back when I played sports. This was from basketball. Another one is, this is my boyfriend right here when he was little. I don't know if you can see that right there. What else? This is him again in his banana PJs. This was, long time ago from when my best friend gave me this Christmas card. I believe it was like when I was in grade 2? I'm not sure. It was Winnie the Pooh. I kept it for that long because I love her and she's my best friend. And I have DeMar DeRozan right here. What else? Food photo booth pictures and just, you know, memories, that sort of stuff that you want to keep because those are memories and you should keep those. Oh, whoops. Something fell. Okay, so let me get started with the materials. Most of these materials I got from, like, the dollar store. As you can see, like, the ribbon over here was from the dollar store. The thumbtacks were from the dollar store. And the tape, I believe, was from Urban Planet. It was only like $3. And what else? The cork board I had from a long time ago. I'm not sure where I got it from since it was like way back. But I'm sure you can buy one from any like stationery aisle in like the drugstores, like Walmart. Or even you can find like a little one at the dollar store, I believe. But the fabric was from Walmart. It was, I believe, like $13, but I'm sure you can get like a cheaper one somewhere else, or even at Walmart they sell the, like the little ones for like $2. Mine was $13 because I got the longer ones. They had like lengthier dimensions, so I got like the extra fabric that came with it, so that's why mine was a little bit more expensive. So if you guys want to know how to make this DIY display board, so just keep on watching.
Uno, dos, tres.
It's been a really, really messed up week. 7 days of torture, 7 days of bitter, and my girlfriend went and cheated on me. She's a California dime, but it's time for me to quit her. La, 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 whatever. La, 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 it doesn't matter. La, 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 oh well. La, 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 we're going at it tonight, tonight. There's a party on the rooftop, top of the world.
What you want to do first is overlap the corkboard with your fabric and make sure the left bottom corner accurately meets the corners of the fabric. So go ahead and glue that baby on the corkboard. Here you just want to repeat that step on the bottom of the corkboard. Make sure that there are no ends sticking out. After you're done that, you just fold over the side and mark where you're going to cut.
La, la, la. We're going at it tonight, tonight. There's a party on the rooftop, top of the world tonight.
Okay, so this step, you just want to repeat the same steps over again for this side. Majority of this video will just be repeating steps, so that's why I'm just fast forwarding everything.
Tonight.
fold it because it's really long. So you just keep folding the ribbon until you create this line, and that line is where you're going to cut.
But when I'm looking at you, I can't ever be brave, 'cause you make my heart race.
So now you're gonna end up with two narrow strips. With the other strip, you just wanna fold it and make sure the two ends meet, and then within that fold, you wanna cut it. So after you're done cutting, you just want to glue it onto your corkboard. Make sure that it's near the end of the corkboard. So here you just want to repeat that step and just glue it on. And then after you're done, you just want to cut off the excess.
So get out, get out, get out of my head. I'm falling to my eyes.
After you're done the first layer, you want to make sure that the second layer is underneath the first one. And then you just go ahead and cut off the excess strip. After you're done gluing all your ribbons together, you just want to push the push pins along the diamond and in the center. Okay, lastly, the not so difficult part is attaching the duct tape along the sides. So all you have to do is attach tape along the sides of the corkboard and make sure to fold the excess along the back of the corkboard where it is invisible, since you're going to be hanging the back part anyways. Voila, this is the final product and it's really beautiful. I like how this one matches my room. Hey guys, thanks for watching my video. Don't forget to thumbs up this video and also subscribe up there. I don't know if it's on this side or on this side. But thanks guys for watching, and like, subscribe, comment, and don't forget to stay tuned for more DIY videos. Bye guys!